Mr. Hiral Shah and my co-speaker Mr. Sachin Gandhi and my friends. At the outset, I would like to thank GSTPAM to give me an opportunity to share my view on provisions of EUA bill under GST. Friends, this is my maiden attempt, so anything would be lacking, please pardon me. Now coming to the subject, starting from the EUA bill. What is an EUA bill? EUA bill is electronic way bill for movement of goods. The concept of EUA bill has been developed from the old concept of way bill. There used to be way bill in some of the states of India, such as Kerala. When you send goods interstate, you sell goods interstate, and you make a transport, the dealer had to offer a way bill from the department and then send that way bill to the vendor, and then the transaction would be complete. So the concept of way bill has been obtained from the old concept of way bill. So way bill can be generated on GST common portal when the movements of good is more than rupees 50,000 in value. So when you are transporting goods worth rupees 50,000 or more, you have to generate EUA bill on the EUA bill portal. And the threshold limit is of 50,000, excluding taxes and cess. If the sale of goods for taxable and exempt is together, then exclude value of exempted supplies, nil rated supplies, and non-taxable supplies. Yeah, if you are selling nil rated goods, exempted goods, and non-GST goods in a particular consignment, then you have to exclude value of that goods from the for calculating the basic limit of EUA bill. Then what are the objectives of EUA bill? Single EUA bill for movement of goods throughout the country. This is the main objective, to prevent the evasion of tax. Then hassle-free movement of goods across India, tracking the movement of goods with EUA bill number, and easier verification of EUA bill by officer with previous verification record. Here the system is mainly developed to track the movement of the goods from one place to another, from where the goods are moving, from which state, and what type of transaction has been occurred. It is like a GPS tracking system developed by the government. Then what are the benefits of EUA bill? As I discussed, there was an old system of way bill in some of the states, not in all the states. We were not having that system in Maharashtra earlier. It was there in Kerala and other states. So as I discussed, the dealer had to obtain that way bill from the department, and then they have to deliver that goods to the vendor, so as the vendor can proceed for the transportation of the goods to the different state. So we had to do the manual process. In e-way bill, everything is online. You don't have to go to the department, request the officer for the way bill. Then average waiting time of mobile squad has been reduced. Here the trader, initially it was difficult to obtain way bill. So in this system of way bill, it is easy, completely easy. The trader can also opt and make an way bill. Then the way bill in this system, government is planning to directly link your GSTR return data with the EUA bill system. So when you generate an EUA bill, it will be the data will be directly picked up from the EUA bill portal to your return. It has not been yet started, but they are planning to. The new system. Then there are various modes of generation of EUA bill, such as you can generate an EUA bill SMS based, mobile application. There is also a mobile application for generation of EUA bill. Then bulk generation, API service, Suvidha providers. The taxpayer can also generate and manage multiple sub users and assign them the roles of EWA bill. Yeah, this is also a thing in your EWA bill. You can generate various sub users, means in a single GST login you can generate various users that can generate EWA bill from various location. As in, if I am running an industry, if I am running a company where my GST number is common, but I am having n number of branches and n number of operators of that branches. If they want to generate the EWA bill, then this utility of sub users helps me to do that. The taxpayer need to take care while managing. Okay. When should an EWA bill be generated? Every registered person who causes movement of goods of consignment value exceeding 50,000 rupees need to generate. In Maharashtra, the limit is 1 lakh. You need to generate an EWA bill in relation to supply for other than supply and inward supply from unregistered dealer shall before the commencement of mode furnish information relating to the said goods in part A of the EWA bill. Then mandatory EWA bill irrespective of value of goods. In these two cases, the EWA bill is mandatory irrespective whether of what amount of goods or commodity you are transporting. The basic limit does not apply to this kind of goods where the goods are sent for a job work by a principal located in one state or union territory to his job worker located in some other state or union territory. Then where the handicraft goods are transported from one state or union territory to another by a person who has been exempted from the requirement of obtaining registration. Handicraft goods have been exempted from registration, or still if they do transport of these goods, they have to generate an EWA bill. Whether an EWA bill is to be issued even when there is no supply? Yes, even if the movement of goods is not caused due to reason other than supply, the EWA bill is required to be generated. Then these reasons include what? It includes reasons other than supply, includes movement of goods due to job work. Either you are sending the goods for a job work, or it is a SKD, means semi knockdown or completely knockdown goods. Then where the recipient is not known, or supply of LPG liquid gas where quantity is not known, supply goods return, exhibition or fair. If you are taking your goods for a certain exhibitions or fair for your own use, means for displaying the goods in some exhibition, you are not doing a transaction here, but still it is, you are not selling the goods, you are just making a supply to another state, still you have to generate EWA bill. Supply goods on approval, if you are sending some goods on approval basis, in that case also you have to generate an EWA bill.
For on-use means personal use or for
own
use?
No, yeah. For own use, it includes for business use. It does not mean to for personal use. If you are buying certain goods for your personal use, you don't have to generate EWA bill. But if you are buying for a business use, that's you have to generate EWA bill. What is a supply in case of EWA bill? Supply may be a supplied of consideration in course of business, supplies made for a consideration which may not be in course of business, or supply without consideration. It includes all the three kind of supplies. Basically, supply means sale of goods and payment made, transfer, say branch transfer. Branch transfer is also included in the definition of supply. Barter exchange system, where instead of money, means when I am supplying some other goods and in return I am taking another good from the vendor, that kind of transaction also included in supply. So in that cases also I have to generate EWA bill. EWA bill must be generated on common portal of all types of movements. The following cases, it is not necessary to generate EWA bill. These are the cases where we need not generate EWA bill. Goods transported through non-motorized vehicles like handcraft. If I am transporting goods by a lorry or by a hamal, or some cycle, so in that cases where it is not a motorized vehicle or motorized transport, I don't have to generate EWA bill. Where the goods are, yeah.
Person carrying the good by all in traveling to train or motor car, is it required?
Yes, it is required.
The vote will be lighting up. What will be lighting the building?
Yeah, that I will cover further, sir. Under custom bond from an inland container depot or container freight station to a custom port, airport, air cargo complex and land custom station or from one custom station or custom port to another custom station or port. Means when I am transferring the goods from a custom within the custom station by using the vehicle or inter custom stations by using this vehicle, that need not generate this bill. Then in respect of movement of goods within such area as may be notified in the unit, then where the goods have been transported are alcoholic liquor for human consumption, petroleum crude, high speed diesel, motor spirits, and so on, that are non-GST products. If I am transferring non-GST products, I need not generate EVA bill. Yeah, where the supply of goods being transported is treated as no supply under Schedule 3 of the Act. Means in case of supply of service or supply of goods, that is employer-employee relationship, such kind of transactions, no need to generate EVA bill. Transit cargo transported to Nepal and Bhutan. Then movement of goods caused by defense formation under Ministry of Defense as a consigner or consignee. Transportation of goods for defense purpose. So the defense people do not have to generate EVA bill for the transport of goods. Empty cargo containers are being transferred. Yeah, even if the empty containers have been transported, if I sign some container for my pickup of the goods from some other state, there I need not generate EVA bill. Consigner transporting goods to or from between place of business and a weighbridge for weighment of distance in 20 kilometers. Yeah. If the consigner transporting certain goods between two places is sending the vehicle for weighing purpose to the weighbridge, if the distance is within 20 kilometers, no need to generate EVA bill. Then consigner transporting goods to or from between here. Goods being transported by rail, where the consigner of goods is the central government. Yeah. If I am transporting certain goods by rail, the government need not generate EVA bill, like in case of other transporters. In case of other transporters, the transporter have to fill the part B of EVA bill. But in this case, if I am transporting goods by rail, government will not fill the EVA bill, any part of EVA bill. Goods specified as exempt from EVA bill required in respect of your state, union territory, GST rule. Yeah. Where the goods being transported are specified in annexure. These are certain goods specified in annexure under Rule 138, subclause 14. These are the list of goods where you need not generate EVA bill. That is liquid petroleum gas for supply to household and non-domestic exempted category. Means LPG gas, अगर हम लोग LPG gas का transport रहेगा, वैसे उस case में हम लोग को EVA bill नहीं generate करना पड़ेगा. Kerosene, oil वगैरह सब बेचा, तो वैसे case में postal baggages transported by Department of Post, natural or cultured pearls or precious and semi-precious stones, precious metals and precious clad with precious jewelry, goldsmith and silver, and in case of currency, and yeah, any goods used for my personal or household use, and the coral and other things, in these cases I need not generate EVA bill. Sorry? If I am taking that for my personal use,
no, personal
use in the course of business. Yeah, if I am taking that goods in the course of business, I need to generate EVA bill.
No, you have to take along with you the delivery charge. Because for UAV there is an exemption for maintenance. Basically, for precious stone and that was the moment, basically they have just maintained for maintaining the privacy. Okay, so and so goods have been transferred from here to there. For that only, basically, this what we say, concession is given. Whereas there is no special concession, say, gold wale alag hai. Only to maintain the secrecy. And among the value, it takes the concession that is given. But when a special goods have been transferred, here to have a delivery charge.
Strong lobby.
Strong lobby करता है secrecy नहीं secrecy I'm selling one crore to be gold. So anyway, हफ्ते में तो यह मत हो जाता है क्योंकि data आपने के पहले उनके बाद पहले पहुंच जाएगा अभी गुड जा रहे हैं.
There are mainly four key players for generation of the UAV bill. The first is the supplier, second is recipient, third is transporter, and the fourth is the departmental officer. The supplier of the goods, supplier can register and generate UAV bill after registering with the website. Further, they can they also have the power to reject if UAV bill does not belong to him. If I am supplying the if I am supplying the goods, then I need to generate UAV bill. Second is the recipient of the goods. If I am supplying goods to some B person, then the B person have to check on his portal the bill generated by me. Then third is a transporter, and the fourth is departmental officer. The departmental officer shall verify the UAV bill and consignment carried under UAV bill. Who can generate UAV bill? Where the goods are being transported by a registered person as a consigner, or the recipient of supply as a consignee, whether in his own conveyance or a hired ones, the said person or the recipient may generate the UAV bill, inform GSTR on UAV bill 1 electronically on the common portal after furnishing information on part B. Then, when the UAV bill is not generated under clause A and the goods have been handed over to the transporter, the registered person shall furnish the information relating to transport in part to transporter in part B of form GSTR 1 on common portal, and the UAV bill shall be generated by the transporter on the said portal on the basis of information furnished by the registered person. But means initially initially if I am selling the goods, I have to generate the UAV bill, and the part B has to be filled by the transporter. And after the transporter fills part B, then only the final UAV bill will be generated. The registered person or the keys may be the transporter. Yeah, even if even if the value of goods which I am transporting it is less than 50,000, still I can generate UAV bill. There is no compulsion that the value has to be 50,000 or more. I can generate UAV bill even if the value is less than 50,000. Who shall generate an UAV bill? Where the movement of the goods is outward is more than 50,000, then UAV bill has to be generated by the supplier or the recipient or the transporter itself. Then where the movement of goods or goods is or any other movement outward movement is more than 50,000, then it is to be generated by the supplier, recipient or transporter. Where it is inward movement from an unregistered supplier, if recipient is registered, is known at the time of commencement of the movement of the goods, and if the value is more than 50,000, then it has to be generated by the registered recipient. That means if I am if some unregistered supplier is returning me back the goods, then and the value of that goods is more than 50,000, then I need to generate UAV bill. Then inward supply from an unregistered
UAV.
But in
case of direct GST bill, outward bill, you have to have direct GST. Any supplier, how this question will come? If you are supplying outside, it will be IGST.
Yes.
You will have it, so
in case of unregistered supply,
because he will have to compulsorily take the registration number if he may make the outward supply.
it's not that thing. If I am supplying to some unregistered, yes. I have to take the number, but the opposite party, whom I am selling the goods, if he is unregistered and he is returning back me the goods, so in that case I have to generate a DWA bill. The unregistered dealer cannot generate DWA bill. Here I have to generate, since it is a case of goods return, so I have to generate EWA bill.
There are separate limits for the dispatch of goods, what value?
Yes.
1 lakh.
Yes. Yes. In state of Maharashtra, we are having a limit of 1 lakh. If it is, if you are transferring goods for more than 1 lakh, then you have to generate EWA bill. In general, the limit is 50,000. If you are transferring goods outside Maharashtra. Interstate, yes. So it, there is a limit of 50,000.
And interstate it is
1 lakh. Yeah, interstate it is 1 lakh. Who shall generate an bill? Yeah, input of capital goods sent by principal to the job work outside the state. Yeah, even if I am sending the goods for some job work, there is no such limit. I have to generate EWA bill as discussed earlier. In case of job work, I think the earlier we had discussed two cases. In case of job work, we have to, irrespective of the limit of transfer, I have to generate EWA bill. And in case of handicraft transport from one state to another, there is no limit of 50,000. If I am transferring handicraft goods from one state to another, there I have to generate EWA bill. All movement of goods less than 50,000 at the option of the registered supplier, it can, as I discussed, there is no such limit. It should be only more than 50,000. If I can generate EWA bill, even if the I am transferring some goods which are less than 50,000. All movement from consigner to transporter or from transporter to consignee within the state having distance less than 50 kilometers, there is no limit. Part B of the bill is not required. Yeah, if I am transferring, if the movement of goods has been occurred from the consigner to the transporter or from transporter to the consignee within the state having distance less than 50 kilometers. If the transfer of goods has been made where the distance is less than 50 kilometers, then part B to be filled. Then what are the various points that need to be noted for updating part B of GST EWA bill? Here, what details they are asking in part B of the EWA bill? If the mode of transport is by road, then we have to put the vehicle number by which vehicle we are transferring the goods from one place to another. If the mode of transport is by rail, then we have to put the serial number and the date of railway receipt. And if the mode is by air, then the serial number and the date of air consignment note, and any other vessel by shipping, then serial number of and the date of that bill of lading. These are the details which I have to put in part B of EWA bill. Who shall update vehicle details in part B? The consignor or the recipient who has furnished the information in part A of form GST EWA bill 1, or the transporter may assign the EWA bill number to any to an other registered or enrolled transporter for updating the information of part B in GST EWA bill form 1 for further movement of the goods. And once the details of convenience have been updated for the transportation of part B of GST EWA bill 1, the consignor or the recipient, as the case may be, to whom it is furnished the information in part A of form GST EWA bill 1 shall not be allowed to assign the EWA bill number to another transporter. Okay. Who can update the details in part B? Speaks about EWA bill part B mein kaun log details update kar sakte hai. Even I myself, if I am selling goods to some other person, I can update, I have to generate EWA bill. Even I can update part B, that is a vehicle number and transporter ka, means other transporter ka enrollment number or GST number. So details ye put karni hai, main bhi put kar sakta hu, yeah, the transporter, I just have to put the transporter enrollment ID or GST number. By that the transporter can view what EBA will have made on in under his GST number or under his enrollment number, and then he can update the vehicle number. Then concept of transporter ID. Transporter are mainly technically speaking, under GST law, all transporters are required to be registered. For the for who holds GST need not do anything to discharge their liabilities by e-way bill or creating the login ID. First, under GST, all the transporter need to be registered. Since they are here, the government is trying to develop a system to track the transportation of goods, to track the delivery of goods, where the movement of goods has been occurred. So in this case, the transporters need to be registered. They need to have a GST number, proper GST number. If they are not having, then they have to enroll for under enrollment form number 1. This is the enrollment form number 1. Just a minute. Yeah. To enroll here, enroll for transporters. In this form, they have to make application. By making an application in this form, it's not working. Nahi chale. Okay. But they have to make application in this form, and after making application, they will get enrollment number. Compliance for e-way bill by transporter. In change of mode of conveyance during transit, where the goods are being transferred from one conveyance to another, the consignor or the recipient who have provided information on part A of form GST e-way bill 1 or the transporter shall, before such transfer or further movement of the goods, update the detail of conveyance in e-way bill, the common portal of part B. Yeah. In case the mode has been changed, in case firstly I have updated, okay, I am transporting goods from Maharashtra to Gujarat, and the mode was changed, okay, that too by a lorry. Now the mode has been changed, okay, I am not transporting that goods by a lorry, I am transporting that goods by some another shipment. So in that case, where the mode of transport is being changed, part B need to be updated by the transporter. Then in case of multiple consignment in one conveyance, where the transporter is moving more than one consignment or one conveyance, he must indicate serial number of e-way bills of each consignment electronically in common portal to consolidate e-way bill. Yeah. If the transporter is transport is carrying more than one consignments, he's not carrying only one of the consignment of mine, he's carrying multiple consignments of various other vendors also in his lorry, or then he need to generate various e-way bills for the various consignments and have a list for them. Where an e-way bill is generated, but the goods are not transported or are not transported as per the e-way bill, that e-way bill may be cancelled within 24 hours. If I have generated some e-way bill, but I have not yet transported that goods, then I can cancel e-way bill within 24 hours of that generation. Then this can be done directly on a facilitation center, or e-way bill can be cancelled if it has been verified in transit where the mode of conveyance has been changed. Okay. It can also, e-way bill can also be cancelled. First off, it can be cancelled within 24 hours by me, and by other way, if the mode of conveyance has been changed, there also I can cancel the e-way bill. Part B of the e-way bill is not required to be filled where the distance between the consignor and the consignee and the transport is less than 50 kilometers and the transport is within the same state. So part B need not be filled. E-way bill can be generated without filling part B also if the transport is within 50 kilometers and that is within the state.
if it is between the two states of the border, like 25 kilometers of Maharashtra and 25 kilometers of Gujarat, so in that case, PVP is still prepared.
Yes. Exactly. Only in case of intrastate movement of goods, the limit of 50 kilometers is applicable. In case of interstate movement of goods, you have to prepare. The invoices or documents to be carried by a person in charge of conveyance. Now, the what documents the transporter has to carry with him? It is an invoice or bill of supply or a delivery challan. And a copy of e-way bill or the e-way bill number, either physically or mapped by RFID. RFID, I think RFID has not been started yet. Yeah, government is trying to develop a system of known as RFID, where you can digitally track and your goods, but it has not been yet started. So the transporter need to carry invoice. Invoice or delivery challan, a bill of supply, or and a e-way bill generated on e-way bill portal. However, the commissioner may notify person in charge to carry the following documents instead of e-way bill. The commissioner, by specific notification, can guide a person in charge to carry the following documents instead of carrying a e-way bill. That is a tax invoice or a bill of supply. Or a bill of entry or a delivery challan where goods have been transported by other than supply. Validity of an e-way bill. If the distance of transport is up to 100 kilometers, up till what time the e-way bill that I have generated is valid. So here, if the distance of transportation of the goods is up to 100 kilometers, then the e-way bill is valid from the date and time at which the e-way bill has been generated, and the time will start from when I generate the e-way bill. Then if it is within 100 kilometers, then 1 day in case other than over dimensional cargo, I will get 1 day for transportation of such goods if the distance is within 100 kilometers. But exception is that of over dimension cargos, where every 100 for every 100 kilometers or part thereof, 1 additional day in case other than other over dimensional goods. Up till 100 kilometers, it is 1 day that the goods should be delivered within 1 day to the place of supply. And if it is 100 kilometers or more, or then additional 1 day I will get from the day. For example, if I am generating e-way bill by today 5 o'clock, so that counting of 1 day will be start from midnight 12 o'clock till the next day 12 a.m. So they will count 1 day that way around, not by if I am generating now in 5 o'clock, then it will be valid up till 5 o'clock. The day will be start from midnight 12 o'clock. Up to 20 kilometers, 1 day as a case of over dimensional cargoes, and for every 20 kilometers or part thereof, 1 additional day. The commissioner may extend the validity period of e-way bill for certain categories of goods. It is upon the commissioner, he can give me extension for the transportation of goods in case these are the specified limits. If the up till this much kilometers, and I will get more than one day. But in case if the commissioner accepts it, then he may give extension for the delivery of goods. Relevant dates. For the purpose of the rule, relevant date shall mean the date on which the e-way bill has been generated, and the period for valid shall be counted from the time at which the e-way bill has been generated. Let us consider a situation. Consider a situation where consignor is required to move goods from city X to city Z. He appoints transporter A for movement of the goods. Transporter A moves the goods from city X to city Y. For completing the movement of the goods, that is this from city Y to city Z, transporter A now handovers the goods to transporter B. Thereafter, the goods have been moved to the destination, that is the city Y to city Z, by transporter B. How will EV bill be generated in such situation? Here, firstly, I am generating the EV bill for transporting the goods from X city to Z city by appointing transporter A, and then transporter A moves the goods from city X to city Y, and it gives the shipment the consignment to some other transporter, and from there city Y the goods have been transported to the final destination city Z by the other transporter. So it has been clarified that in such scenario, only one e-way bill would be required. In this case, where I had generated, if for example, समझो कि अगर मुझे e-way bill मुझे महाराष्ट्र से गुजरात final goods पहुँचाने थे, मैंने एक transporter appoint किया कि वो मुझे मेरा goods deliver कर गया, but वो transporter ने पहले वो goods ये राजस्थान वो लेके गया और दूसरे transporter को उन्होंने मेरे goods दिए, और वो जो second transporter है वो राजस्थान से फाइनली गुजरात में गुड्स लेके गए. अल्टीमेटली द गुड्स फाइनल डेस्टिनेशन पे पहुंच ही गए मेरे. बट इन सच सिनेरियो वेयर द शिपमेंट हैज बीन रूटेड थ्रू टू डिफरेंट स्टेट्स, सो देयर आल्सो वन ईवे बिल इज सैटिस्फैक्टरी. सो हियर द पार्ट ए ऑफ फॉर्म जीएसटी ईवे बिल कैन बी फिल्ड बाय द कंसाइनर, दैट इज बाय मी. वेयर आई एम ट्रांसपोर्टिंग द गुड्स, पार्ट ए नीड टू बी फिल्ड बाय मी, एंड द पार्ट बी of the e-way bill has to be filled by the transporter, and he needs to amend part B when he is making a change of whether he is changing the vehicle or the route. So in all that scenario, it needs to be amended by the transporter. On reaching city Y, the transporter A will assign the said e-way bill to the transporter B. Thereafter, the B will be able to update the detail here. As I discussed, कि समझो A यहाँ से goods राजस्थान तक लेके गए, तो वहाँ तक A ने खुद का detail means A transporter ने वो detail खुद का update कर दिया कि हाँ यहाँ से ये particular vehicle में ये particular lorry में goods गए. वहाँ से lorry भी vehicle भी change हुआ, mode भी change हुआ, तो और दूसरे transporter ने handover किया, तो वहाँ पे वो transporter A ने वो अपडेट करना पड़ेगा कि वो फर्दर कौन सी लॉरी में गुड्स ट्रांसपोर्ट होने वाले और कौन से डेस्टिनेशन वो पार्ट बी में अपडेट कर सकते हैं. सिचुएशन, कंसीडर सिचुएशन वेयर कंसाइनर हैंड्स ओवर हिज गुड्स फॉर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑन फ्राइडे टू ट्रांसपोर्टर, बट द असाइंड ट्रांसपोर्टर स्टार्ट्स द मूवमेंट ऑफ गुड्स ऑन मंडे. आई थिंक ऐसे सिचुएशन काफी हम लोग रूटीन में आते रहेंगे कि हम लोग ने ईवे बिल असाइंड ट्रांसपोर्टर started the movement of the goods on Monday. Okay, मैंने goods Friday को hand over कर दिया transporter को for transportation purposes. और but वो जो transporter है उन्होंने वो जो particular goods वो Monday को after वो Monday को उन्होंने deliver करना start किया. So how would the validity of e-way bill be calculated in such scenario? मैंने तो जब ही transporter को goods provide कर दिए तब उन्होंने तब मैं वो बेसिस पे मैंने ईवे बिल जनरेट किया, बट द ट्रांसपोर्टर हैज नाउ बट उन्होंने जो मूवमेंट ऑफ गुड्स है वो आफ्टर स्पैन ऑफ टू डेज उन्होंने वो मूवमेंट स्टार्ट किया. सो इन दिस केस इट इज बीन क्लैरिफाइड दैट द वैलिडिटी पीरियड ऑफ ईवे बिल स्टार्ट्स ओनली आफ्टर द पार्ट बी हैज बीन फिल्ड. या मेरा जो वैलिडिटी है, इवन इफ आई हैव फिल्ड पार्ट ए ऑफ ईवे बिल, वो वैलिडिटी वहां से स्टार्ट नहीं हो जाएगा जब से मैंने पार्ट ए, जब पार्ट बी ट्रांसपोर्टर फिल करेगा और जब एक्चुअल ट्रांसपोर्ट बिगिन करेगा तब से वो वैलिडिटी गिनी जाएगी, नॉट के मैंने जब पार्ट ए भर दिया और वो गुड्स असाइन कर दिया ट्रांसपोर्टर को तभी. इन डिटेल्स ऑफ ईवे बिल जनरेटेड अंडर सब रूल 1 शैल बी मेड अवेलेबल इन द रिसिपिएंट इफ रजिस्टर ऑन द कॉमन पोर्टल हु शैल कमिट एसेप्टेंस और रिजेक्शन ऑफ द गुड्स कवर्ड बाय ईवे बिल. द डिटेल्स ऑफ द ईवे बिल जनरेटेड ऑन द सब पोर्टल जो मैं ईवे बिल जनरेट कर रहा हूँ, जब मैं ईवे बिल जनरेट करता हूँ, आई हैव टू पुट ऑल द डिटेल्स टू हुम आई एम डिलीवरिंग द गुड्स, जिसको मैं सेल कर रहा हूँ गुड्स, वो उसका लोकेशन कहाँ से मैं गुड्स सेल सप्लाई कर रहा हूँ, वो लोकेशन है मेरा जीएसटी नंबर और सामने वाले का जीएसटी नंबर, मुझे सब फिट करना पड़ता है। सो जब मैं ये सारा डेटा जीएसटी पोर्टल पे डालूंगा, तो जो सामने वाला पार्टी है जिसको मैं सेल कर रहा हूँ, उनको वो पोर्टल पे उनके जीएसटी पोर्टल पे ये ईवे बिल हाईलाइट होगा कि मैंने उनके नाम पे ये पर्टिकुलर ईवे बिल रेज बनाया है। सो देयर ही हैज टू, ही और शी हैज टू एक्सेप्ट दैट ईवे बिल एंड दैट टू विदिन 72 आवर्स। इफ द अगर सामने वाला कन्फाइनिंग, वो मुझे लगता है कि नहीं ये ईवे बिल जिसने जनरेट किया है वो प्रॉपर नहीं है, देन ही कैन डू रिजेक्शन विद इन 72 आवर्स। एंड इफ आई वॉन्ट टू, इफ आई हैव जनरेटेड सम रॉन्ग बिल, देन आई कैन कैंसिल दैट बिल विद इन 24 आवर्स। Where the recipient referred in sub rule 12 does not commit his acceptance or rejection within 72 hours of the detail being made available to him or the common portal or at the time of delivery of such goods earlier, it is deemed to be accepted. अगर जो recipient है जिसके नाम पे ईवे बिल मैंने बनाया है, अगर वो accept और reject नहीं करेगा, then it will be assumed as deemed to be accepted by the recipient. A registered person may obtain an invoice reference number from the common portal by uploading on the said portal a tax invoice issued by him in form GSTR invoice 1 and produce the same for verification by the proper officer in lieu of tax. Invoice or such number shall be valid for a period for 30 days from the date of uploading. Whether registered person uploads the invoice under subrule 1, the information of part A of form GST EWA bill 1 shall be auto-populated by the common portal on the basis of information furnished to GSTR. As I discussed earlier, the government is trying to merge this EWA bill portal with GST common portal. It is trying to pick up the direct to directly pick up the data from of EWA bill, that is goods transported for where the limit is more than 50,000 or more than 1 lakh. वो डायरेक्टली आपके GSTR 1 रिटर्न में पिकअप हो जाए, दैट इज द ट्राई ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट। सो द कमिश्नर मे बाय नोटिफिकेशन रिक्वायर अ क्लास ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टर टू ऑब्टेन यूनिक RFID एंड गेट द डिवाइस एनेबल्ड। देन शॉपिंग ऑफ व्हीकल एंड वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंट, द कमिश्नर और एन ऑफिसर, प्रॉपर ऑफिसर एम्पावर्ड बाय हिम इन दिस बिहाफ may authorize the proper officer to intercept or any conveyance to verify the EWA bill or the EWA bill number in physical form for all interstate and intrastate movement of the goods. Commissioner or the या तो जो officer government ने appoint किया है वो कोई proper officer को appoint कर सकते हैं। He has the authority to stop the vehicle in mid road and he can confirm all the details, he can cross check the invoices and wo EWA bill ke sare details aapse pooch sakte hai. The commissioner shall get RFID reader installed at place where the verification of movement of the goods is required to be carried out, and verification of the movement of goods shall be done through RFID reader where the EWA bill has been mapped with RFID. RFID actually ek device hai jo it has not been yet started here, but it is a device where they can track your movement of the goods. Then physical verification of conveyance may also be done in case there is a specific information of tax evasion. Physical verification of conveyance, yeah, if there they are having information that tax evasion has been done, जो अगर ये पर्टिकुलर लॉरी जो ट्रांसपोर्ट हो रही है उनको अगर इन्फॉर्मेशन है कि ये इट द डीलर इज इन सम इलीगल एक्टिविटी और ही इज ट्राइंग टू इवेट द टैक्स, द ऑफिसर हैज अ राइट, ही कैन स्टॉप योर व्हीकल एंड ही कैन डू फिजिकल वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी गुड्स इन द लॉरी. इंस्पेक्शन एंड वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ गुड्स, अ समरी रिपोर्ट ऑफ every inspection of goods in transit shall be recorded online by the proper officer in part A of form GSTR EWA bill 3 within 24 hours of inspection, and the final report of part B form GST EWA bill number 3 shall be recorded within 3 days of the inspection. जो प्रॉपर ऑफिसर जो गुड्स स्टॉक करता है और इंस्पेक्शन करता है उसे वो रिपोर्ट देना पड़ेगा. ही विल गिव द रिपोर्ट इन फॉर्म जीएसटी ईवे बिल फॉर्म 3 विद इन द 24 आवर्स. उसने जब इंस्पेक्शन कैरी किया वो पर्टिकुलर ऑरे को रुका के उसके 24 आवर्स के अंदर उसे वो रिपोर्ट अपलोड करना पड़ेगा एंड दैट शैल बी रिकॉर्डेड विद इन 3 डेज ऑफ इंस्पेक्शन. वेर द फिजिकल वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ गुड्स बींग ट्रांसपोर्टेड और ऑन एनी कन्वेयंस हैज बीन डन ड्यूरिंग ट्रांजिट एट वन प्लेस विद इन द स्टेट और इन एनी अदर स्टेट नो फर्दर फिजिकल वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ सेट कन्वेयंस शैल बी कैरिड आउट अगेन इन द स्टेट. If assume कि अगर एक particular एक proper officer ने मुझे एक state में रुका के already verification कर चुका है so further movement में भी कोई proper officer मुझे रुका के वो he cannot halt the transport और वो verification नहीं कर सकते. When first proper officer will do verification he will issue me a receipt that he has verified the goods and documents and I can move further. So even if further भी मुझे कोई proper officer अगर कोई वो मेरे transportation में रुका हुआ डालेगा तो फिर I can produce that receipt to him and I need not wait means do verification at each and every state or even if I am transporting interstate. For example if I am transporting it from Maharashtra the proper officer has halted the lorry in Maharashtra at Maharashtra borders के for verification. If I have been checked at Maharashtra borders and further also if the proper some proper officer holds my good for verification then I need not stop I can produce a receipt to him so I need not give each verification in each and every stage. Once the verification is done it has to be uploaded by the proper officer in EV bill 03 form 03. Facility for uploading information regarding detention of vehicle where a vehicle has been intercepted and detained for a period exceeding 30 minutes the transporter may upload the said information to form GSTR EV bill 4 on the common portal as if a proper officer halts my vehicle then he can only for verification purpose he can only halt for 30 minutes if he halts my vehicle for more than 30 minutes then I can take a complaint in EV bill form number 4 against the officer that his consequences for non-generation and not getting EVA bill for the consignment value exceeding what are the consequences if I do not generate EVA bill where the value of goods is more than 50,000 below penal provisions may get attracted for not complying with EVA bill rules section 122 where the taxable person who issues any invoice or bill without supply of goods or services or both in violation of the provision of the act or the rules made there under or transports any taxable goods without the cover of document as may be specified in this behalf he shall be liable to pay a penalty of 10,000 rupees or an amount equivalent to the tax evaded whichever is higher. If I do not generate EVA bill or produce the documents which have been specified which need to be carried by the transporter while transporting the goods that we had discussed earlier that he needs to carry a delivery challan, he need to carry my tax invoice, supply invoice and along with the EVA bill. If he is not carrying this document and if he do not produce this EVA bill then a penalty of 10,000 rupees or amount equivalent to the tax whichever is higher will be applicable. This is a kind of flowchart I have created where a penalty showing the penalty here penalty and the section 129 where the owner of the goods come forward if I have not generated the EVA bill and if I agree to that I have not generated EVA bill and I am ready to pay the penalty in case of taxable goods the penalty is tax plus 100% of tax amount and in case of exempted goods it is 2% of value of goods or 20 rupees 25,000 whichever is lower and if I do not agree to pay the penalty and if the proper officer denies that then in case of taxable goods it is tax amount which I have evaded plus 50% of the value of goods in case where I had agreed there it was tax plus 100% of tax amount Here it is where I am not agreeing to pay the penalty, and where with the proper officer, it is I have to pay penalty of tax plus 50% of my value of goods. There it was 100% of value of tax. Here it is value of goods. And in case of exempted goods, where the owner had agreed and come forward to pay, it was 2% of value of goods or rupees 25,000, whichever is lower. Here, if it the owner does not agree in case of supply of exempted goods, it is 5% of the value of goods or 25,000, whichever is lower. I'll set some procedures here. How does taxpayer enters Part A detail and generate e-way bill when he is transporting goods himself? If I am carrying my goods by myself and not through a transporter, some transporter, then sometimes taxpayer wants to move the goods himself. E-way bill portal expects the users to enter a transporter ID in the so if he wants to move the goods himself, he can enter his GST in the transporter ID. Okay, where I am transporting the goods and I want to generate e-way bill, but I am not delivering that goods through transporter. I am delivering by myself. I am making doorstep delivery. So in such case, I need to put some details in Part B. I need to put the details of transporter in Part B. There, what I will put? I will put my own GST number instead of the transporter GST number, and the vehicle which I am using to make the transaction, to make the delivery, I will put that details. When does the validity of e-way bill starts? When validity of a e-way bill, when it will be counted, from what time to and from what date? The validity of e-way bill starts when first entry is made in Part B, that is a vehicle entry is made first time in case of road transportation, and first transport document number entered in case of rail, air, ship transport. Yeah. When I enter details in Part B of the e-way bill, just a minute, I will show e-way bill. So, Sachin sir, mane e-way bill portal start thai shakshe ma maro login. सेट नहीं कर रहा हूँ, एग्जिट करना, एग्जिट और नहीं बैठ नहीं तो सर लॉगिन. So this was this is a GST portal where I have to make e-way bill. So I can generate e-way bill here, generate new. So this is Part A where I have to provide supply type, then subtypes of supply, that is normal supply, job work, SKD, CKD, recipient or not. Document number, that is my invoice number, invoice date, and transaction type I have to select. From from where it has been billed and from where it has been dispatched to which place it has been dispatched or shipped. And item details I have to describe here. This all description I have to give in Part A. In Part B, I have to give the mode which I am using for transportation of the goods, the vehicle number, and the vehicle type. Okay, so So the value, I come to back to my presentation. So if the validity will start when I will fill, even if I have filled this part A, but I have not yet filled part B. So will not be generated until I fill part B. I enter in this vehicle details, whether it is my personal vehicle or the transporter vehicles. So validity will only start when I fill part B. What has to be done if validity of the EV bill has expired? If the validity of EV bill has been expired, the goods are not supposed to be moved. However, under circumstance of exceptional nature and transshipment, the transporter may extend the validity of the period after updating reasons of extension. The time has been set for transportation that so and so particular goods have to be delivered at so and so place within the stipulated time. If that stipulated time has expired, so the transporter can offer further extension of the time by updating part B of e-way bill. How to extend the validity period of e-way bill? There is an option under e-way bill to extend the validity period. This option is available for extension of e-way bill further before 4 hours and after 4 hours expiry of the validity. Here transporter will extend the e-way bill number and enter the reason for requesting for extension from place, that is current location, to the appropriate destination to travel. So the transporter can make the extension by amending part B, and he has to give the reason why the goods have not been delivered within the time given or the time specified in e-way bill by amending part B. So in case of breakdown, so here the transporter has to make amendment in part B. He has to specify the reason why the goods he is unable to deliver the goods within the time specified in e-way bill. He has to specify the reason for not delivering the goods on time as specified in e-way bill. He can mention the reason in part B that the goods have not been delivered due to the vehicle breakdown or due to some other reasons.
There is no communication which can't.
Such practical difficulties are
actually
there.
Yeah.
But we have to bear with it. The first moment that he gets some network, he has to intimate the opposite party at least pass this entry to his transport office. If it is breakdown, you have a standard drop down menu where he can select the reason that there is a vehicle breakdown. Therefore, there is some reason.
Whether I have to apply. If he does not specify, then the tenor is completed. Because if he want to extend the time, he has to give reason for non delivering that goods, and if it does not specify, the time limit exists. Supplier will be penalized. And say if I am transporting the goods through transporter, but even if there is a mistake of transporter, I will be penalized for that. Is the EVA bill applicable even if the movement of goods is by a courier? If I am sending goods through a courier, so in that case also, whether I have to apply for a e-way bill? Yes, I do have to apply for a e-way bill even if I am sending that goods by courier agency who are regarded as transporters. All provisions applicable to the transporter under e-way bill rules. Uh-huh. whether EVABLE is required to be generated for movement of goods from a unit of a company to another unit through its own vehicle. If I am transporting the goods from my own unit to some another unit or some other branch, and that is also within 50 kilometers, do I need to generate EVABLE in that case? Yes, in case of branch transfer, although it is within 50 kilometers, I need to generate EVABLE. Whether the date of invoice and the date of EVABLE must be the same, it is not necessary that the EVABLE should be generated at the when I generate invoice. Is EVABLE required in case same conveyance carries three different invoices, each of them valuing less than 50,000, however the total of them exceeds? If in case where I am sending three different consignments in a transport, but each of the consignments value is less than 50,000, none of it is more than 50,000, but if the sum of it is more than 50,000, what whether I have to generate EVABLE in that case or not? So as per sub rule 1 of rule 138 of CGST rules requires that every registered person who causes movement of goods or consignment value exceeding 50,000 is required to generate EVABLE. Hence, as per the rules, EVABLE may not be required to generate if the value of consignment is less than 50,000. But further, sub rule 7 provides that where the consigner or the consignee has not generated from GST EVABLE number 1 and in accordance with the provision of sub rule 1 and the value of goods carried in conveyance is more than 50,000 rupees, the transporter shall generate GST EVABLE 1 on the basis of invoice or bill of supply or delivery challan. A plain reading of the subrule gives an indication that EVABLE is required in case where the value of consignment or conveyance exceeds 50,000, even though individual value may be less than 50,000. In simple, I will conclude, even if I am transporting goods in one vehicle and with three different consignments I am transporting in that vehicle, each of value below 50,000. But the total value, if it is exceeding 50,000, then I need to generate EVABLE. Is EVABLE required for movement of goods billed as services such as works contract, composition, supply, job work? Yes, EVABLE is required to be generated in relation to goods even for the purpose of supply through whether there is any movement of goods for consignment value exceeding 50,000. In case of works contract, composition, supply or job work also, it is required. Is EVABLE required for movement of samples costing 50,000 having no commercial value? If I am transporting free samples through the vehicle, but means which are not having any commercial value, but the costing of that good is more than 50,000, the manufacturing cost is more than 50,000, where I am not selling it and it is used as free sample. So the commercial value of that even goods is zero, but the making cost is more than 50,000, and if I am transporting such goods, still I need to generate EVABLE. Is EVABLE required for movement of warranty replacement parts or repairs valuing more than 50,000? Yes, EVABLE is required to be generated in relation to supply or even for purpose other than supply. Therefore, whenever there is a movement, any movement of goods or consignment exceeding 50,000, means even if I am sending back some machinery on warranty basis for repairs purpose, which value is exceeding 50,000 rupees, still in that case also I need to generate EVABLE. Just skip some poses. How the distance has to be calculated if the consignment are imported from or exported to other countries? The approximate distance for movement of consignment from a source of destination has been considered based of distance within the country. If I am exporting or importing certain goods, so how will I calculate the distance and for EVABLE? So here the approximate distance for movement of consignment from the source of destination has to be considered as a base or distance within the country. That is the case of export. The consignor place to the place from the consignment is leaving from the country, means from my place, from my business place to the port, up till the port I have to calculate the distance. And not if I am exporting certain goods to say US or UK, then I need not calculate the distance from India, from my place of business in India to United States. I just have to calculate the place and generate eBay bill up till the port from where I will ship the shipment from outside India. Whether eBay bill is required if the goods are being purchased and moved by consumer to his destination himself. I think sir asked me some question. Yeah, if I am whether eBay bill is required to generate if I have purchased and move for my own use. Whether eBay bill is required if the goods are being purchased and moved by consumer to his destination himself. Yes, as per eBay bill rules, eBay bill is required to be carried along with the goods at the time of transportation, even if the value is more than 50,000 under the circumstances. How to generate an eBay bill for multiple invoices belonging to same consignor and consignee? In case of where I am making various where I am issue supplying various commodities for which I have made various bills to a particular consignor. Consignor E K, जैसे मैं goods send कर रहा हूँ, sale कर रहा हूँ, is the one person itself. But various अलग अलग goods sell हो रहे हैं और अलग अलग invoices बन रहे हैं. But shipment एक ही जा रहा है. So in that case, where I am issuing multiple invoices, how will I generate eBay bill? If multiple invoices are issued by the supplier to recipient, that is the movement of the goods is of more than one invoices of same consignor or consignee, multiple eBay bills have to be generated. That is, for each invoice, one eBay bill has to be generated, irrespective of the fact whether same or different consignors or consignees are involved. I have to generate various eBay bills for various consignments. Then, how to generate eBay bill on? I'm skipping some poses. What? Bill to ship to? Yeah. Issues regarding bill to ship to for eBay bill under CGST rules 2017. In a typical bill to ship to model of supply, there are three persons involved in transaction, namely A, a person who has ordered, B to send goods directly to C. Let us take an example. If I am telling Sachin sir, who I am residing in Maharashtra, Sachin sir is residing in Delhi, and I am telling Sachin sir to deliver goods directly to Hiral sir, who is residing in Gujarat. So it is a case of bill to ship to transaction, where bill has been made. I will bill to directly Hiral sir, who is residing in Gujarat, as I am selling the goods. But the goods have been delivered from Delhi by Sachin sir to Hiral sir in Gujarat. So here, in this case, also here. Sorry, I will continue with this transaction only. It is a bill to ship to transaction. A is a person who has ordered B to send goods directly to C, and B is the person who is sending goods directly to C on behalf of A. Yeah, C is the recipient. In this complete scenario, two supplies are involved, and accordingly, two tax invoices are required to be issued. First invoice is by B to A, and the second invoice by A to C. Then who would generate the eBay bill for the movement of goods which is taking place from B to C on behalf of A? Either A or B can generate the eBay bill, but it may be noted that only one eBay bill is required to be generated as per the procedure. So in this case, where the movement the person from where the movement of goods has been occurred, that is from he may generate e-way bill or I can generate e-way bill, but only one of the person can generate e-way bill. Then cases where e-way bill is generated by B, the following field shall be filled in part A. And in case where here we are deal with the person, I am saying B to deliver goods directly to C. So here, where e-way bill has been generated, is been generated by B. So what we should need to fill in part one, part A of GST form number one, that is bill from it will be the field detail of B, who is used to, who is supposed to supply, then dispatch from. This is the place from where the goods are actually been dispatched. It may be the principal or additional place of B, and not my place of A. The actual seller is A, but the supplier is B. So here we will where e-way bill has been generated by B. The place of dispatch would be B's place of business or any other additional place of business of B. Then in bill to section, it will be B would bill to me and not directly to C. Sorry, means to A and that not directly to C. And ship to C is supposed to be filled. C's address is supposed to be filled. Invoice details need to be filled. In other case where e-way bill is generated by A, the following fields need to be filled in part A of GST form e-way bill 1, where e-way bill has been generated by the original seller and not by the supplier. So here in bill form, it will be the A is supposed to be filled. Details of A is supposed to be filled, then dispatch from, in the place of dispatch from, the goods have been actually been dispatched from the place of B. So here we will put real good details of place of supply of B. And build in build to section, details of C need to be put, that is the final consumer. And in ship to place of C, that is final consumer. Registration process for enrolling e-way bill under web-based mode. You can enroll for e-way bill. You can get registered on GST portal. This is the GST portal. You can get your registered here on this portal. You need to get to register on the e-way bill portal. Just a minute, actually, to do it practically. Net is not working. Okay. Actually, the net is not working. Otherwise, I was to present. But I think all would have been knowing the registration process, how to get yourself registered on the e-way bill portal. There is also a facility of one-time enrollment for GST unregistered transporters. The transporters who are already been registered under Old Service Tax Act, they are by default they will get registered under GST. But in case of unregistered transporters who are not registered under earlier act, neither they have been exceeded the limit of GST turnover and they have not been registered, so they need to register, they need to get one time enrollment for e-way bill. Unregistered transport registration process for enrolling e-way bills through SMS. You can also do registration process for enrolling e-way bills using SMS based application. Then they have also prepared an Android app where you can track your e-way bill and you can even make an e-way bill or get registered. You can download that app and you can generate an e-way bill through that Android app also. So I'll conclude my session. I have not covered many of the things due to the time constraint. I'm sorry for that, and please pardon me as it was been my first lecture. If
included him.
Thank you.
You would agree with me that Gaurav Parekh's first attempt was a maiden.